Since we know that force is equal to the time derivative of linear momentum, we can write, by multiplying by dt on both sides, that dp is equal to f dt. We can integrate this, and we're left with, on the left, the integral of dp just gives us p, evaluated at our final time minus our initial time. And on the right, the integral of f dt is something that, if we had force as a function of time, we could put that in and evaluate that. This change in momentum we call an impulse. And we define that impulse as j is equal to the integral over that time interval of f dt. What that lets us do is it lets us talk about a change in momentum based on this impulse. So the impulse is equal to this change in momentum, or m delta v, which is our change in momentum assuming a constant mass, will be equal to that impulse of force. More frequently, I like to think of it as whatever initial momentum I start with, I add on the impulse, and I end up with my final momentum. But it's mathematically equivalent to the formulation that we have in the nice typeset equations here. If you have a tennis racket, for example, here, we can see that as that tennis racket contacts the ball, it can impart an impulse onto the ball during some brief amount of time that it's in contact with that ball. And then we can describe the motion of the ball using that. So we say that the little bit of impulse due to the little bit of time is that dj, defined as f dt, and then you could integrate that impulse to get your overall impulse. In practice, actually describing the forces in these very short collisions can be kind of tricky. A lot of times it's convenient to use average force. Here we have an average force, and you can see that if you integrate over your time interval and then divide by that time, that'll give you your average force. Here you can see a function of time, force as a function of time versus time. And if you integrate here, you get the area under this curve. That's equal to the same area under the curve if you take the average force and multiply it by that delta t. So this is just a graphical representation of what we have over here. The integral of the actual force, which maybe starts high and then tails off, is equal to, if you had the average force, just multiplying it by the delta time. That means that we can say that our impulse is equal to our average force times delta t. And this is true. This is just a true statement. That's actually not really assuming anything. That average force times delta t will give you your impulse. In general, you wouldn't expect that average force to actually be the real force you're feeling during the impact. So if you need the real force for some reason, then that's not going to give it to you. But it will give you an idea of, again, the average force. We can replace this impulse with, since we've said that the impulse is equal to the change in momentum, we can say that that is now equal to my change in momentum, m delta v, assuming that we have constant mass. And this right here is pretty powerful and explains a lot of things. For example, airbags. If you think about impacting in a crash, as I'm crashing, I want to crash and have as long of a time as impact as I can, so I can have as short or as low of a force, average force of impact as I can. The change in linear momentum is going to be the same because you're moving with some mass and velocity, and then at the end of the crash, you're stopped. So this side is going to stay the same, but this side, by lengthening the time involved in the crash and absorbing the energy and other things like crumple zones in your car and the airbag, you're also lengthening the time in the crash, and that reduces the average force that you feel during that crash. You can also think about like dropping an egg on a pillow versus dropping it on concrete. The change in momentum is the same because the egg starts off falling and then at the end, it's staying there stationary. But with the pillow, there's a decent amount of time for it to compress that pillow. And so your average force during impact is much lower compared to concrete. It's a very sharp impact. It stops really quickly. With that time being so low, the average force of impact is much higher and your egg is more likely to break.